What's up, y'all? I'm Megaza, and at a video vlog. Anyway, y'all, before we jump right into this, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment down below, and hit that bell. Now, excuse what I have on. I've been trapped in bed all day. Now, practically, I'm kind of upset because, like, I had someone knocking on my door. But when I got up to go to the door, I didn't see nobody. So I don't know what the heck is going on. I could hear them talking shit, saying, oh, she ain't shit, this and that. Saying negative stuff about me. But when I got to the door, it was nowhere there. It sounded like a dude talking about, I hope she dying, this and that. Now, my walls are thin. My TV is down. Ain't nothing really going, but when I finally got halfway there, I heard them go down the stairs, and the time I get there, I ain't seen her. So, you know, I'm gonna give them applause for saying negative shit about me. And I'm back. Obviously, I don't care. It's a round of applause. And I don't even know. I'm not cooking nothing! Damn! Every time I got your freaking hand on the thing, I'm gonna come on. I'll be back. Now we got the other one. The other one be, this one be, it be testing every day, all day. It is safe, testing. It doesn't matter what time it was. It just be beep, 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 beep. Then we got the other one. Beep, beep, beep. Now the other one on the wall, every time I have my heater on, if it's cold in the house, I want to turn my heater on, the shit want to cry. Then if it's not that, is it this one just went off. I just took the other one off. I put it in my dresser jar, put it in the closet, it still go off. Right now, I got it under a damn fucking blanket. You can't twist it and take the battery out. You can't do none of that. You really can't do shit to it. You can't even get the battery out. Just like this one. This one's annoying. This one got a freaking hole right there. But back when I was saying, I clap for the people who talk negative shit about me in high school. Especially like, you know, I already know they don't want me to be here. They so whatever. And I already know it's a negative shit. Like, you judging for who I am. Hey, it's cool. It's what it is. I say my name, I keep to myself. I stay in my own house, but there's so much negative stuff I be around. It's like, it's what it is. Like, no one want to see you everyone want to see you down. So basically, everyone see me down. So I give them that clap. I give them a clap from knocking on my door talking shit because I don't know who it is. And then, it's what it is at the end of the day. That's how they feel. At least they give them what they want to say. Because me, I really don't have no friends at the end of the day. I stay to myself, practically. And I can tell that these people don't want me next door. But I've been here right before they have. But I'm not about to come here and judge or whatever. But there's a couple times I left my key in the door because I had to go to the restroom. Or I was pissed up in the house and they knocked on the door and gave me my key. That's about it. I miss my old neighbors. Me and my old neighbors was like this. We was very like this. But I miss them. I miss being around my old people, but it's what it is. It's what it is to make them happy. And I feel like I'm missing some papers from my door because they've been missing. But anyway, I did not come on here for that. I came on here. I got flies in my house. Why? That's a good question. I've been killing flies all this week and last week and that. Why? Because when they tried to fix my door, they put tag came back and fixed my door. And months been by, so they can't fix my door. So in between my door, you when the sun hit, the light just goes, it shine right through my front door. So it's easy access for flies, any type of bugs to come through my door or whatever. And I got a whole family in the window was been dead. Just creating more or whatever. I'm tired of killing flies though. And it's like my bedroom window. I finally got a screen up. It took I don't know how many years to get a screen up. And the window don't close all the way. So, and the screen not all the way on. So there's flies coming in that way. It is, I don't know. I am done making complaints. I'm done calling in. I just feel like the people don't give a fuck in the office or whatever. And I know it's time for me to move regardless. But I can't move at this moment because the social security place don't know when they're going to open up. I need to get a whole nother social security card so I can go apartment hunting. Right now, I'm going to be here for another year. I don't know. But I got to figure out what I'm going to do because on the internet, on my account, it does not it's not actualizing my username or my password to get a social credit card, whatever, the bill. So I'm just like, I'm just barementing, just going with the flow, keeping to myself. The old me, when I did move to her, I was like on top of stuff. I was going back and forth with them and all like that. You know, you get tired of that. It's what it is. I don't know. Everybody is different, you know. You know, I can still do the same, but at this moment, it's like, it's what the hell. Hey, I'm the handy woman, handy man. I refix some stuff. I fix my thing and then back messed up again. But I didn't come on here and talk about this problem or whatever. I came on here. Before I open my refrigerator, have I been eating? No, I have not been eating. I think I'll just shut down because people just saying so much negative stuff and everything. But it's like, I don't care at the end of the day. But it's what it is in my agenda or whatever. And, you know, a negative shit is what it is. Like, but I'm not the type of person gonna talk negative about a person. If you wanna do something, be yourself in life and have a goal, I'm gonna boot you up. But anyway, let's get to it. This video is sponsored by my refrigerator. Now I really don't have no food in my pantry or whatever. But this is my refrigerator. So I'll be cleaning out my refrigerator. And I'm sorry I can't turn my camera around. But I will be cleaning out. I deep cleaned my house yesterday. I cleaned up yesterday. And look like I gotta go over my floor again. And this is my refrigerator. This is trash. I'm throwing all this away. This is been in whatever. Yes, this is this ice pack. So I don't know how I'm gonna set this up. Will I be getting food up in this refrigerator? No, not really. I supposed to have cleaned my refrigerator last week, but I'm just cleaning to be on the safe side. You're always supposed to keep up with your refrigerator and clean your refrigerator and everything else. But I don't want no food in my house. Like, I'm just on a diet. And by stopping myself, that's the best way, because I've been losing inches. So, I barely eat. So, and I do drink water. But let's start with the freezer, I guess. This is the top part. I got a bucket already, a pot, whatever. Already. So, and I still got some tea left or whatever. Basically, I'm gonna clean this, but it's late at night. It's like 11 o'clock. It should be 11. Is it 11? Oh, it's 10:39, and I don't feel like walking to the trash can late at night. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to clean this out, and I'm going to put this back in, and I'm going to throw this away tomorrow. Because I don't feel like doing all that. And I think it puts a rain. Could have rained last night. Okay. So, let's get started. But I think the person who was talking negative was my ex who had came over here. But he said he never trusted me. I don't know why. I did a whole lot of shit for that nigga. I didn't do nothing to him. I just been going through it all, okay? I just been going through it. So, you know, people like to see me down, hey. But people be so freaking jealous when I be up. They be trying to bring me down. Like, if I tell them something good, they have a funky-ass look. I don't do other people like that, but that's how they, that intimidate character, they don't too much like me. But I'm like, you don't too much like people, but why you fuck with me then? Just to be in my business or be nosy and then come knock on my door and say shit, but just to come in and be nosy, no. I don't like that. That's how I stay to my stuff now. Like, I don't really, people be like, oh, why you don't open up much? Because I don't trust people. So we're going to listen to Not No Sexy Music, because if I listen to something sexy or something slow, I'm going to be back in my fucked up feeling. So, speaking about it, tell me why when I'm with my, one of my homegirl we was going to Gabbison, whatever. We pulled in her apartment, and I seen my first love with some girl. That ain't the only time that shit happened. I feel like they be doing that shit on purpose to make me jealous, because they know, you know, I don't have no one, and I'm single, and all that other extra stuff. I don't like that, though, but it's what it is. Is that what make him happy, make him feel good? Hey, that's what's up. Around is the plot in the back. Hey. But it does hurt me deep and down, because I'm still hurt at the same time, and I'm still trying to heal. And I'm dealing with other stuff besides him. I'm dealing with other stuff around here and everything. But it's like, I don't care. But at the end of the day, it's still going to be in your mind regardless. I just try to put it behind and just move on. However. But My stomach got small. I want my hips to get smaller, though, but my stomach got flat. But yes. We're gonna put it on some slow music. French fry, ice chop, cat's eye, let's get to this. Pork chop, soda pop, scallop, kebab, sour sauce, pot pie, dumpling, chicken wing, pecan, onion ring. I don't know what this was. My mom gave me this. My mom be talking about she be having food for Thanksgiving, but I tell her I don't want it. I'm like, nah, I'm good. I'll be like, sometimes I tell her, like, oh, I get it another day or another day, and I don't get it. I don't. I just be like, but I don't want no food in my house. Like, period. I think I already died in my house. I almost died twice. But that was not my fault. That was that salad. And I think I shouldn't have saved myself. That's how I feel. I think it was time for me to die right then and there. Cause your heart only could take so much. This I did not want. This been up in the refrigerator for like, no, this been in the fridge for like 3 or 4 months, maybe longer than that. And I got a whole lot of candies that I did get rid of and throw away. But when I be having people over here, I try to give them stuff. I don't know what this is, but it's not no ice cream. But ooh, this is so good. So this is how my food is looking. Everybody I will take this out, but I got one sink already swilling up with water because I got my dishwasher ready. So I'm gonna try to clean this ice up in here. Naughty lads get naughty, girl. It's only one or two. Leave us fucking running, feel the heat between us two. No, I understand how niggas could do so much to a female, if you could do so much to you. Like, don't y'all be exactly. I'm sorry, but I really don't got a problem with nobody. It's like people got a problem with me, and the staff, like, because I don't really know them, but people got a problem with me, and I don't really know. That's sad, but it's what it is. It's called, like, whatever I have, they don't got. That's how I look at it. And I go with everybody. Whatever you have and they don't have, they always gonna hate or be jealous off of you. Me, I don't even got time to be jealous off of no one because I live alone. And I gotta run by my own self. And I gotta take care of my own. Like this, but it's still good. Nope, I take that back. It's not. I don't too much like it though. It's brown under. I saved containers. Ooh, I'm glad it didn't fall. Now up in here. So when we went to Galveston, my friend had bought me a margarita drink, and I didn't drink it because I was the driver. So I had to drop my name from back. And I just poured my whole margarita up in here, and I poured some half and half Arizona. And then when we finally came back to Houston, I had some Arizona fruit punch, and I'm just mixed all of it up in here. I still got butter left. This is old. This is trash. Okay, when I don't have no water bottles or water, this is emergency for waters. This fire at 12, 12, 31, 20, 31. This is when I run out of water bottles and this is emergency, case for emergency. They got it coming in this kind and then it coming to this. Okay. And this pot is just rice. That's all. It's just rice up in here. I need to find something to hold the door open, so I'll be back. Okay, guys, so I'll be back. Oh, yeah, why people be complaining about my dog? My dog don't even really bark. The only time she barks is like when someone knock out the door. Y'all got soaking wet, so my shirt's about to be bleached. And let's finish. Yes, I'm sitting in the chair. Normally, when I clean my refrigerator, I take out the trays and put them in the sink and then wash them. But when my sink is fucked up, I can't do that. This is a lazy ass job right here, okay? But what I could do. Because all half of it wasted on the floor. Please do not judge me how long I'm doing this. As long as getting clean, that's what matters. Shit. Stop. I should have cleaned that and then kicked that out. That's what I should have did. This one be getting stuck sometimes, so I don't know if I'm gonna take this one off. So, this it gets stuck and it's not sticky, it has been like that. Okay, I should be back. So, y'all, what is that? I don't know what that is, but I'm glad I'm cleaning it up.
So up and down lately. Do you think our investment plan's still on track?
I'm gonna clean my walls too. I cleaned half of my walls yesterday. I just didn't do all of them because it was late and then it started thundering and lightning yesterday. So the only thing I didn't get a chance to do was my refrigerator. my half of my walls and my microwave. Now everything else I cleaned up. I cleaned the whole restroom, the kitchen, I vacuumed. I did a whole lot yesterday. And I was tired too, doctor. And then I wound up checking the mailbox. I have not checked the mailbox over like 4 weeks. I've been in the house for 4 weeks. I finally went out to Galveston. Sometime this week I finally got out. I've been in the house for like 4 or 5 weeks. I'm a homebody. I don't go out. And I just finally went to check the mailbox. I didn't want to check the mailbox. But, because I know every time I go to the mailbox, it don't be nothing. But at the same time, right now, at least I got a roof over my head. That's what matters. That's what counts. But I wanted to show y'all my pantry. How my pantry's looking. So I guess we start at the bottom. I got that. This is me and my ex-best friend. We were leaving the park and we found that, so I went ahead and taking it. It was at the park. This is this containers what I have, like rice, noodles, cornflakes, a little sugar, pinto beans. This is, one of these are empty, but I got two flowers down there. This is just like the little sauces and everything, and my little candies. I do not want that tuna. I don't too much like that tuna, to be honest. And this is just empty, I believe. So that's the rest. I got tea, ketchup. I got some little Kool-Aid packs that you put in the water bottle. That I'm trying to get rid of up there. I don't want that. Some of that I do not want. But it's what it is. This is how my pantry is. I wish they actually supposed to have another one of these on top of there. For most apartments I've been into, some people have like this going to the very top. So I'm missing one up there though. But I'm not ungrateful. At least is what it is. I'm happy what I got though. But yeah. And somehow my my coffee machine, when my ex boyfriend was here, I used to look at the coffee every time he go to work in the morning. I try to show him how to do it. I know he didn't break it. It had to be someone else. Like, I think I know who broke my coffee machine. I know it was not him, though. But, yeah. I always wonder. But did I have this like this? Or I just had it like that. Oh, I did. I'm sorry, y'all. Hold up. Stay back. I meant to say stay tuned. That's what I meant to say. I don't know why this teeth thing is up in here. I do not know why. This actually needs to be right. I need another shelf. I need some room. Cause I got some more of these, but they can't fit. But yes, that's how my pantry is. Or whatever. I don't know what's wrong with me. I probably do know what's wrong with me. Why I don't want to eat. I don't know. But at the same time, I think I know because I don't depress and all that other stuff. And I'm just like, damn, I should, like I told one of my friends, for me to miss that ex and still love an ex and still have feelings and care about that ex, I should not have to feel like that. Because, two, he put me through a whole lot of shit and he hurting me and he beat me and all like that. I should not have to still have love and all like that and still be a feeling. Yes, I moved on. I did move on. I'm still single and saying, I am trying to talk to dudes, but at the same time, the niggas, they just want sex. They'll pay for it. They're like, oh, I know you got some good pussy. You never been up to me. Tell me, oh, I give you $300-$400 to fuck you. Like, that's every nigga think about out here. And then one nigga be telling me, oh, I don't got a girl. Found out they got a girl on the side because they call my phone. Or found out they say they don't fuck with their baby mama. Found out they do fuck with their baby mama. Like, it's so much. So, it's like, at this moment, people just trying to get it in at this moment. People just trying to get some pussy and dick. And then I got to look at the fact, like, this nigga didn't fuck one of my homegirls. Then turn around and send my sister a dick picture. Like, this nigga said, why is I still have feelings for this? This nigga moved on and did him. Or whatever. So, it's like, I need to do the same thing. But, like, at first, I was over him. But then people keep asking me questions about him, and then shit, it just put me back in that same category again. And then I'm over around on a whole lot of stuff. I wonder if this is still good. This is like corn mix. It has been up in here about what, 2 months now? I don't know. So we're just gonna move on to the top.
This is so good. I've been looking for this at other stores.
As you can still see, I still got tape from my refrigerator when I had first moved in. Like, this I never used until I started having people spamming me. They started using this, but when I was here by myself, I never used it. It just had tape on it. This, like, the ones at the bottom, which y'all see with the onions and, the lemons up in it, I gotta throw them away. Before I get to another subject with them lemons, I never use these vents. Never. Never use these vents until, like, I started having people spamming me. Like, I used to have tape on them. So, this is, like, my first time seeing stuff up in them. Okay, now the lemons. What I do with lemons, I used to, use it for my face or whatever. And when my sister was here, she used to use lemon for her underpits. For deodorant lemons. She cut a lemon and put it under her underpits. I don't know. That was her style. When she didn't have no deodorant. It's what it is. But I used lemons for my face. A couple times I used it for my hair. But like I was saying, I really don't open up to people because I don't trust people and I really don't have no one to be honest. And then like people who I do talk to, they gonna go back and spread rumors and everything. So it's like basically I keep stuff to myself. You know, that's the only person you can trust is you and God. And then, like, most people on my page be like, oh, you need to die, and this and that. You know, they be saying the negative shit, but, you know, I just say thank you. So, it was an end. That's how I take stuff. But they people go to say stuff when y'all threw stuff away. But I just think that when people say stuff about you, they might be getting blessed at this moment, but God could flip the table around, and you don't gotta get blessed for nothing. So you gotta be careful what you do to people and be careful with how you treat people. If I wasn't on camera, I would have let my refrigerator air dry before I put everything back up in here. But I don't want my camera to cut off. I am freaking hungry. I would have a camera out so y'all could see that how I miss days without eating. Sometimes I don't really want to be drinking water. Like, I will poop the whole day without eating. Sometimes I get full without eating. Mom, tell me y'all don't know. This is my hair treatment stuff for my hair. And I have a spray. And my water, I don't know if y'all can see, but I got, I know y'all probably can see it. It's not filthy dirty, but I'm happy. The water is still clean. That means my refrigerator was not all the way dirty, which that's a good thing. And my water is still hot, it's not cold. Stay tuned, y'all. I will be right back. Ooh. Okay, y'all. I had to get some more water. And I think I drained the last time, so I got some more water. My house smells so freaking good. Like, I get so many good comments on my apartment, but then it's like negative people who don't know me, who done never been. They're like, oh, she got a dog, or her apartment stank. Like, you never even been in my apartment before for to say that. But you know what? I take that love, and that's how you feel. That's how you feel. Shit, it's what it is. Like, oh, God. I tell you today, it's sad that I help so many people out. I mean, I help a whole lot of people out. And then for my ex to say a whole lot of shit, I'm like, God damn, nigga, I help you out too. Like, and I help his family out. But his mama didn't have a freaking TV. I swear I gave his mama my TV. And the sad part, that TV my cousin gave to me. I shouldn't have did that though, but we went to go get her and she kept complaining that she didn't have a TV and her new place. So I said, hey, I didn't get her mine because we was on our phone. It's sad that I did that and my cousin was mad at me. My cousin was really mad. And then another time it was sad, like, when I ain't had no money to pay that bills, I helped out. Everybody have food, I helped out. I'm like, but it is cool how they did me, though. Like, I'm not sure. I don't be looking for blessings, to be honest. Like, I help some people out. I don't help people out just for blessings because I don't look for blessings. And I never really haven't had no blessings, to be honest. So I'm just not tripping off of no blessings. I just like to help people out, though. Even though baby prayer is by breaking and stealing and doing stuff to me, though. But it's what it is. So I got a pack of strips up in here. It's a pack of strips. Oh, I just got a bundle. I got a pack of this. I need to get me some containers. I did have me a container with like all that ketchup I seen. I did have containers for that. I don't know what happened. I don't know. I like my ranch cold. I'm looking at this. I need to see the date. It's still a few left up in here. I got a whole full ketchup. Oh, I got some Wendy ketchup too. Not Wendy. I mean Whataburger ketchup. I feel like all the ketchup tastes the same. This says 0740. May the 22nd. Okay, wait. May the 21st. So I think this is expired. I'm trying to read the date. It say May. Oh, 2016. May the 22nd. Okay. This gotta be old. Expired the 21st. Yes, this is trash. Let me put that trash. This is trash too. No, I mean, I don't leave stuff in my refrigerator for that long. Cause I be throwing it away. And I'm still like upset, like this nigga, I don't even talk to myself, my like this nigga fuck my cousin too. That's another thing. I would never do someone like that. Like one of my other cousins was stemming me, her boyfriend was there. I used to tell her how her nigga used to do this and that. And I used to think like she gonna give her a nigga, and I used to tell my ex her nigga was trying to do to me and everything. Like, see, I'm a real life female. And then, like, long years ago when I had a homegirl, I told her about her baby daddy, how her baby daddy was trying to do stuff to her. Because I don't want to lose a relationship from a family or a relationship from a friend. Even though I did lost one relationship with one of my homegirls because of her baby daddy, but I kept it real with her. Even if I was going to tell her or don't, she was going to find out. But I told her anyway, but I didn't do nothing to the nigga. The nigga kept messing with me. Like, he would not stop. But at the end of the day, her nigga was cheating on her.
anyway with another female. He was cheating on her.
That's how we like. I don't understand these niggas. Like, when a female bring their friend around, I guess the nigga be okay to mess with the female friend, and she's supposed for her not to go tell her friend or cousin, whoever, what's going on. I'm not like that. If I'm around one of my friends and her nigga be trying to talk to me, so I'm gonna tell her. I'm gonna keep it real. So right now I'm watching the little corner side right here. But people look at me dumb and stupid and slow as fuck. Anyway,
people always say that, so it's what it is. I'm not tripping.
Whatever make them happy, I'm happy for them.
But I feel like maybe me and my ex could have fixed stuff up and be back together again, but I don't know. I don't know if I done that.
I'm almost done with my door. Flip it round, IPE, and let's see if this goes far. Full of truffles and cuddles and sometimes eye puddles. Compose love like we're Mozart. Yeah, a whole lot of ranch.
I wonder if this is fire. It still looks like it's good though, but I just want to see when does it expire.
I say if I buy some more ranch or whatever, I'm not gonna open it into. I think I got a ranch up in there in the refrigerator that I'm not going to open. Well, I do need to put some of the stuff was open. I do need to put it in the door so I can keep it fresh. I'm gonna have to, I swear I still got tape on this freaking door. Oh, hey, y'all. So, I am done with the doors. Hold up. There's a little bit more. Okay. I don't know if y'all can see, but I'm done with my doors. Let me just do open up so it can breeze. Then I gotta wipe the side under it. Okay. Hold on. I'm gonna need it. I really don't drink like I used to drink. I used to drink a lot. I don't drink like that. I don't even smoke like that. I really do this stuff like that. Oh my gosh, y'all. I bought this at Fuma Ramen. It's alright. I think I'm gonna put it in the refrigerator because it's open. It's open. Certain stuff I don't. Like, I got a whole freaking cash that was not open. I might take that off the refrigerator. Okay, so I'm gonna put this up in here. And then there's other stuff I'm gonna put up in here because it's open. And I just wanna be still fresh. So whenever I cook again, I could just take it out and let it warm up or whatever. Is this old? I think I'm gonna throw this away. This is so good with chicken. Like, you cooking chicken and everything, it had a whole house smelling so good. So, I'm gonna put this right here. He's gonna throw that away. I think I'm gonna throw this away too. I got too much ranch. I hate when certain stuff don't got no damn date on it. That should be pissing me off. This is still good. It still got stuff up in here, y'all. I need to get rid of stuff like this. I swear, I need pouring stuff like this. I got this much left. This is gonna inspire into next year. Some of this stuff I'm gonna have to throw away. Some of this stuff I gotta throw away. I can't even keep this stuff like this if I really want. This still got stuff in it, so I'ma hold that up. I know y'all like, damn, is she gonna throw it away? She could get some more. I know, but I'm saving because I like to get every little penny worth. Every little penny. Is this open? Oh no, it's not. But then it's still chill, so I'm not gonna. It's not open. I'm too much ain't a ketchup fan. I'm too much like this. I don't know, this got fitting here. That's it. I'm not a mayonnaise person, but when people come here, hey, we still got mayonnaise, or whatever. I don't keep nothing on my bottom shelf, so I just keep this at the bottom, my hair, whatever. So, this already, I wonder will this fit over here. Nope. It will fit, but I don't know if it's gonna stay over there. How the heck that one? I'm not about to force this to stay over there. Like, if it don't want to stay there, it don't want to stay. I'm gonna put that back right there. I'm gonna put this right here. This is so unorganized. I like to be organized though, but it's a journey. I'm not the person who does her. I want HGTV Home by Sherwin Williams. I might just throw this away. Oh, I hate mayonnaise smell. I don't like it. I like my jelly to be cold. I like cold jelly. 24 seconds, yeah, you better not stop. Okay, so this is how. I used to sing, I don't sing no more. I used to sing in different gospel groups and everything. I used to travel, but I don't want to do all that. So this is how it's looking. My water, this, and this, and this, and this. I might rearrange my door because I don't too much like it how it's looking right now. I don't like this. I like to keep my stuff organized. And this not right. This not the business for me. And I'm like really organized right now. Yeah. I can't stand when stuff is unorganized. It will irritate me. It irritates the shit out of me. Yeah. Okay, so I got stuff to throw away. And therefore, I gotta clean the outside of the refrigerator. Then after that, I'm gonna clean my doors, and then after that, I'm just gonna throw some other stuff away that I don't want. But yeah, this is my beautiful refrigerator. Ain't nothing in it though. But yes, I hope everyone enjoyed this video. Like this video. Give a thumbs up. This is my first time doing something like this. She scared the crap out of me. She think I'm eating.
scared the mess out of me. But yes, I am done. Whatever. I'm finished. And will I be eating some tonight? I think I'm not. I need to look at these onions because I know how to make onion rings. All you need is like flour, eggs. Yeah, I got to throw some onions away. And I will be, the only thing else I got to clean is these little things. The little jars. That's all I gotta do. Then after that, I'm done cleaning my refrigerator. And then after that, be wiping my walls, like I said. Perfect. But anyway, I hope everybody liked this video. I'm just trying to shorten it because I don't want to have it to be a long video or whatever. And if you just going through stuff, just pray to God about it or whatever, you know. Oh, no. That's my opinion. But there's so much I'm going to say, but I'm not going to say. Yeah, my skin looks so, I don't know what. My skin looks so bad. What is that? Oh, that's the sticker. I like, what is that? That's the thing, we keep the refrigerator thing on. But yeah, my skin looks bad as heck. But yes, I'm getting old. I look bad, but that's what it is. I don't know. Me and my ugly Steph and I about to get off of here, and I hope everyone enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up. I don't know if I'm gonna get some food because my stamps, they don't give me a whole lot of my stamps. My stamps only last for like 2 or 3 days, that's about it. And if people come over to chill and I do offer people stuff, my stamps just gonna last probably about a day. But I looked it up how much a person supposed to get by their stuff, and the way how they doing me is what it is. I can't be ungrateful, at least it's something. That's all I like to say. But it's not much, so it's what it is. I really don't get much of my stuff. And then, fortunately, I would have to wait a whole freaking month. That's how I'm so used to starving my stuff. I would have to wait a whole freaking month just to get my stuff. A whole freaking month. That's why I'm just so. And I've been starving myself ever since I was growing up as a kid. So that's why my body used to it. Or whatever. But it's what it is, you know. I struggle a lot, so it's what it is, you know. You gotta make it happen. Hey, you pick the choice, or you want your own place, do this and that. And that's me. I picked that choice. Like, I'm in my own place. I be. You supposed to be out your mom's way before you hit your 20s. But there's some people still in their 20s. There's some people still in their 30s. They still trying. At least they trying. At least they haven't gave up. At least they ain't been incarcerated. At least they getting somewhere and got somewhere, you know. And it's always a good thing to motivate yourself, you know. At least you got something going for yourself at the end of the day. It's what it is. You know, you can be at your own house or their house because you choose to be there to help them out. Or maybe they're going through a bad condition or something they're going through and they need help around the house. Hey, at least you there, a helping hand, you know. But I choose my condition to leave because, you know, I don't got time. The rules, okay, there's plenty of rules. My mama's old school and it was cool, but I know I always could go back to her house. But I had to think about that for a second. Let me tell y'all something before I get up here. I'm trying to let my friends really air dry. I'm gonna say, if I ever come back, I gotta be in the house at 6 o'clock in the evening or 7. I think she said 6. Yeah, she said 6. It's been like that ever since I was a kid growing up. I had to be in the house for a dark kid. Oh my gosh, so my friends will tell you. I had curfews. But having my own place. Do I be hanging outside late? No. Because I really don't have friends like in California. That's a different story. If I go to my friend's house, I'm gonna be out late. That's not that. But I really don't be doing nothing. I just be chilling at the house bored. Bored, losing my damn goddamn mind. I read the studies when they say if single women are single, they get irritated at 7 o'clock. They stay on the site to 3-something. That's what it say. This girl wrote that on her status, which is true. Being single is cool, but at 7 you get irritated and some other shit. It's something else she said, which that's true, because I've been single for the longest. For the longest. And I see why, and I've been focusing on myself. But there's men be coming my way, but the only thing with the men be coming my way, they just only want to fuck. Or they want money. I ain't no damn gold digger. I ain't no money tree. Ain't none of that. I don't open my legs. Like, I be gonna start like, what the fuck do I be sitting back when I be just telling me stuff. I'm like, oh, really? I don't sit like this. I be just sitting up like proper. In my head, I be like, what they thought I was. Like, yesterday, one guy, I just met him. He said, what you doing? I said, chilling. He said, oh, I'm in Fort Worth. I said, I don't know the north side. I'm from California, whatever. He was like, oh, I'm on the north side. I was like, oh, okay. That's what's up. I said, don't you need to go home before it start raining. Because it was raining and lightning. It was thundering and lightning outside. He said, nah. He said, I'm trying to get some booty. I'm like, oh, that's what's up. Remind ya, I just met this dude the other day. We only talked on the phone about like a half an hour. The other day. Not yesterday, but the other day. But yesterday, he hit me up and said all this. So, I've been on for 2.5 days. 2.5 days like that. So, he was like, yeah, I'm trying to get some... Mind you, I'm 34. He's 40 years old. He was like, I'm trying to get some booty. I was like, okay, good luck with that. He was like, yeah. He was like, I just need some booty. I said, well, I hope you have some condoms. He said, yeah, I do. I said, that's good, because I was good to stay protected. He like, man, where you at? He like, I'm coming to your house. I like, I'm a little whore. He said, I want that booty. I said, He like, man, you know, I got that money, whatever. So he started playing. So I'm like, oh, okay. And he like, I ain't no gold digger. I ain't looking for money. I got my own money. That's what I'm saying. He said, man, how much you would charge me? In my hand, I'm bagging up. Now, I was about to hang up the freaking phone, literally. I was really about to hang up. So I stopped saying, this is what they just do nowadays? He said, how much y'all charge? I'm like, okay. I said, in my hand, I said, I'm about to play with this nigga. I'm about to play with him. I ain't say nothing nasty, none of that. He just said, how much? I said, $250. He said, damn. God damn, for some pussy. He like, I don't even want the ass. He like, I just want the pussy. I said, yeah, $250. I'm like, you look at me, I ain't say $550, whatever. He like, god damn, you charging that much? I said, yeah. And then he was like, why so high? I'm like, because this is some good ass pussy right now. And I said, it's still some good ass pussy, because therefore, I haven't been fucking that way. So I know. And half of my exes want, half, I ain't gonna lie, some of my exes want me back, but I don't want them. Because they know I got some good pussy. They know that I cook and clean and do other stuff. But nah. I'm good. That's maybe the 90 happy one. I do miss him. I kind of want him back. But anyway, back to what I was saying. I'm like, this is some good ass pussy for $250. He said, damn. He said, how about $100? In my head, I said, no. I said $250. And I asked him. I said, I'm not about to take your money. And I'm like, my pussy is not for sale. I'm like, I'm not that type of female. I'm like, I just wanted to see what you want to say. That's how come I said $250. I really wanted to see what he was going to say. He was like, I said, that's what y'all doing now? He said, yeah. He said, you got to get in. He said, what he said? He said, money does talk. I said, yeah, money does talk, though. But at the same time, while you out here for some pussy, money talks versus diseases and everything. And me, I'm clean. I don't got nothing. And I'm not trying to fuck nothing. And I'm not trying to have someone to give me some money just to fuck me. And he tell me, I can keep money in my pocket. Okay, that's fine, but I don't want that. 2, condoms does bust, it does rip, bam, there go baby, STD, herpes, whatever. Shit, I don't sell my pussy for no one. I'm sorry. He like, well, man, what about this 100? He said, well, what about 40? I like, nah, I'm good. Then he asked me, I can get some food, whatever. I said, I'm good. I'm like, where did they go with food? And I'm like, huh? I'm like, you said food? He said, no. He was like, I'm like, what you want? He talking about, he called, I thought he said food. Then he was like, nah, he called someone out the window, a damn fool, because he was yelling at people out the window. So I asked him, I was like, what you on? He like, I ain't on nothing. I'm like, you drinking? He like, nah. Then I'm like, what you really on? He like, what he said?
He said that quarter, that nickel. I said, what the fuck you know about that quarter and nickel and dimes and everything? He said that 50-50. I said, how you know? That's that California talk right there. That's that weed shit. I'm like, you smoke weed? He was like, of course I do. He said, I'm from Louisiana. No, he said, I'm from Los Angeles and California, whatever. I didn't mean to say it right though, but I was like, oh, I'm like, okay. I'm like, what you be smoking? I said, you be smoking like Kush? He was like, oh, no. He like, I be smoking that good. I'm like, well, you smoke that Reggie, that OG? He was like, nah. He was like, I smoke that good. I like that gas. Like, I started naming every type of weed. And I'm like, this nigga, 40 years old. I'm like, wow. He like, I can get some weed, too. You want me to? And I could have smoked and blow it in your ass and fucking all night. I'm like, nah, I'm good. And he kept going, and he like, so where you at? I said, oh, I'm not at home. He like, god damn, he like, you suck. I'm lying, said I'm not at home, which I was at home, though. He like, you suck. He like, where you at? I told him, I said, the day when I met him, I said, I'm not going to be home, I'm going to be gone. I said, I'm going to be at my friend's house. That's what I was telling him. I like, and I had repeat, but I had said that today. I said, you didn't know. I'm like, you don't remember when I had told you that I was not going to be home Friday? Today, Saturday, right? Yeah, today, Saturday. I like, because I told him that Thursday and Friday, I was like, you know, I told you, I said, I'm not going to be home. He like, oh, yeah, I forgot. He like, so when you going to be back home? I'm lying, saying Tuesday and Wednesday, I'll be back home. He like, god damn, that's a long time. He like, you just can't come again. I like, hell no. I said, nigga, it's plenty of stitches in the sea for you to go find some pussy. And then I told him, I said, if it hurt that so bad, why don't you just go to the store and get you some Vaseline or some grease or something, look at some pornos and check the fuck off. He gonna tell me, man, I'm tired of that. I don't want that. I want the real shit. I like, well, I feel you on that. But he like, I want the real shit. I'm like, okay. He kept going, so I'm like, okay. I'm like, it's time for him to change the subject. He gonna tell me if I feel him on that. He said that we should fuck. I said, nah. I like, I'm just feeling what you said. Because most niggas be saying that same ass line. And I get tired of hearing that same ass line. But every other nigga say, that's how I try to cut it off. Because he kept talking so much. That's the same, oh, I feel you. And I was trying to change the subject. So after that, I'm like, he kept talking. I'm like, ugh. In my head, like, niggas will do anything for sex. He won't, and he said, I could change my mind. He like, I change my mind because I wanna get inside of you. So he want me to be with him. No, I'm good. I tell him, I said, my sister calling me. I gotta call you back. And he was like, okay, bye. And that was the end of that. So I hung up. I didn't want to deal with it. I just hung up and I had talked to my friends, and I told my friend about it. And I said, why do niggas do shit like that? Like, I don't understand that. Then I got another dude whom I met. He a rock star or something. He played in a band. So we talked for the first time on the phone. And after that, he got to my, he started questioning about marriage and everything. He said, I want you to be my woman. I want you to marry me, this and that. Like, the next day, like, I don't even know you. Like, you just met me in 5 seconds, and you already talking about marriage. He ain't white. I don't know. He ain't black. He's some kind of race. Even the other one was, too. But I like, I be telling, I tell him, I like, I'm not looking for, I like, I'm trying to focus on myself. We could be friends. But, niggas is just so obsessed to be running to fuck me, and it's not happening. I guess it's so, I'm not gonna judge females out here, but I guess it's so freaking easy for females just to lay down and do it, because most niggas are my homeboys. They told me some females out here are so fucking easy just to have sex with, and I'm not one of them. I'm not one. I'll chill with you. Just like one. Ooh. Before I end this, hold it. Before I end it. Just like I had one. I went ahead and stepped out the box. And I met one dude. I let him come over. We was talking. And from there, he asked him. He wanted to have sex with me to make this one wanted to have sex to make a video. I said no. I'm like, damn, you gonna fuck me on the first day? You just met me the same day. You wanna, no. No. I like, no. He wanted to, no. No. But he was cool. I felt his vibe was good. But that is just, you gotta go. No. And then I had another one. I had one dude who I've been knowing for a year. And I found out he do pornos. And he got mad. He don't know. He got mad. He don't know. But I don't know if he. I don't know if he's on my YouTube channel. But he don't know. I pretend to be another female, even though we chill. We saw another person because he know who I am. But he don't know. I had another number, and I'm just texting him acting like some other girl. And my voice. I'm like, damn, this nigga. This nigga don't, he can't tell it's me. I'm acting like a whole nother person with a different voice. And he starts sending me different all location and address and everything. And it just amazed me because he think I don't know what he do. So he start like at 4 o'clock in the morning, he sent me a porno video. I text him, I said, this you? He said, yeah. Why? I saw two niggas. Correct me if I'm wrong for this, okay? I saw two niggas. Him and another nigga, no condom. Both of their dicks is rubbing together going inside a girl mouth. The girl is giving both of them head, but she placing both of their dicks together. Okay, then a couple days later, he sent me another video. He don't know that I know that he do pornos. I'm pretending to be someone else still. Then he called me from another number. I'm playing three different females. Three different females. And I'm playing myself too, so I make it four. Out of all three, he don't know it's me. Now, he sent me another video. Correct me if I'm wrong. So, when I, he called me at 2 in the morning. He said, what you doing? I pretend I'm at work. I'm like, I'm at work. He like, oh. I'm like, he like, what you doing? I'm like, I was eating this hot link or whatever. That was my last meal, too. So, that was like 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, one or two. So, he like, oh, you on break or something? I was like, yeah, I'll get ready to go back to work or whatever. And he like, what time you get off? And I told him. And he gonna tell me, well, I thought you said you was off. I said, nigga, you just asked me what time I go back in. And I just told you. He was like, oh, my bad. He like, well, we need to do that. Can I ready to eat that pussy and fuck you up and all like that? And I said, I'm laughing. I said, I gotta go back to work. He like, okay. He like, make sure you hit me. He sent his location. He ain't call back. After I hung up, it's funny to me. After we hung up, at 5 or 6 in the morning, he called me from the other number. Remember, I'm acting like a whole other girl. So he called from the other. I'm like, God damn. I'm like, what time is it? He said, morning beautiful. He like, it's 6 in the morning. I said, what the fuck? So I'm already up. I'm pretending I'm asleep. So I'm up. I said, nigga, he got me wired up because I'm a thought. I said, first of all, I'm like, you do porn on time. I said, nigga, that's nasty. He like, what are you talking about? I'm like, you got your dick and his dick rubbing together. That's gay. He said, no, it's not. He said, you got to get it in some type of way and make your money. He said, that's not gay. I said, first of all, if you pull up a gay porno and see two gay mans or whatever they call themselves, gay, lesbian, the other word, I can't think of the other word. It's something else. It's something about time. And you see them in the video rubbing his dick and his dick together, and they rubbing their dicks and humping or whatever, and playing with both of their dicks at the same time, and it's hitting one another dick without no condom. Man, that's fucking gay. Now, he was like, man, don't do that. Because I told him, before we even got to, I said, correct me wrong, I said, I don't want you to feel some type of way. That's all I said. It was something I told her. And then he said, go ahead and hit him. So I went ahead and told him. It's the way how I said it to him, though, but I can't remember that. But I've been questioning everybody. Everyone said, that's gay. Two mans together, rubbing their dick together, and what the fuck, that's gay. Okay, but with him and the other nigga in the video rubbing their dicks together going up and down, and the girl about to put both of them in her mouth, that's still gay because we're both touching one another dick at the end of the day, but at the same time, understand, like, he got to get his and she got to get her, and the other nigga got to get his suit, though. But in the video, it looked gay to me. It just looked gay. I don't know. Maybe I'm not saying it right. I don't know. But
rubbing two men dicks together and they ain't about to pick up from in your mom. I guess, but he said that's his money. That's how he get his money. Now, later in the evening, he called me. He called me. He like, what you doing? I said, chilling. At first, when he see me, he was blowing up my motherfucking phone. This is right before I even planked this shit out. He was blowing my phone left and right. He was trying to come see me and this and that. And if I wasn't thinking about doing that, I would never know he do pornos like that and rub his dick with another man dick. Rub like the two pee hole dicks together, or however you want to say it, the two side dicks together. I would never knew that. But the nigga been sending videos to the other number. And I'm just like, wow. And then I tell him, I said, you know this girl? He like, yeah. He like, that's the homegirl. I'm like, you be fucking her? He was like, yeah. He was like, she clean. I say, you be fucking her and he fuck her. But how you know she could be fucking someone else? And you fucking this girl without no condoms. I'm like, I guess. That's how they trust people. But I feel like at the end of the day, it's what it is. If you trust that person, you trust that person. But at the end of the day, if y'all friends with benefit, fuck from fucking buddies or whatever, friends with benefit, fuck from buddies. Y'all could be fucking around, but they never know that other person could have someone else they fucking with, or they could have someone else. That's why they say they got condoms for the side ones and the ones for the main ones without condoms. That's what every nigga say. That's what it is. Oh, I had one dude, he came over here, and his breath smelled like chitlins. God damn! He started kissing on my neck and everything. I was like, I said, He asked me, why are you making the funny faces? I'm like, well, I can still smell it in my nose. He was like, I love chitlins, though. But he said, it's time for me to go. I said, yeah, it is time for me to go. I gotta go to sleep. Yeah. No matter how many times I cleaned my damn neck, the scent never left. My scent didn't leave until 3 days later. I mean, I took 4 or 5 baths. Like, I was not expecting this dude to kiss me on my neck. I was not, literally. Like, I was just sitting on the bed. And he, like, I have a bed and I got a chair. There's a chair that sometimes I have my company come in the room, sometimes I don't. It just depends how long I've been knowing him, because I'm not that stupid or whatever. And then I had a weed tray and I had stuff on my chair and whatever. So I was like, well, I got a smoking session, because he was trying to give me the smoking blunt. I said, no, I'm good. So the reason why we didn't chill in the living room, because you could smell gas. I stayed by a gas pipe. And it lit. You can smell it in the house. And it just, and it's outside, so you can, like, smell it.